Good morning, guys. Welcome to GoOnlineTrainings.com. So today let us have the Pivot and Unpivot Transformations in MSBA, part of SSIS. So let us understand what is a pivot transformation. Pivot transformations, nothing but convert rows into columns, or this also known as it makes normalized data into denormalized data. So unpivot transformation is this converts columns into rows, or denormalized data, you have to make it to normalized data. For example, now I have some data here. I have a name column, I have a course column, I have a marks column, I have Kiran, I have Java 80, I have Kiran MSBA 90, I have Ravi Java 78, I have Ravi MSBA 99. Like that, I have some data in source. Now what I'm trying to do, Java is a row, MSBI is a row, okay? So the Java MSBA has become a column here. So converting a row into column is known as a pivot operation, okay? So now Java MSBA, Java MSBA, these are rows now became columns here. Now Kiran and Kiran Ravi have a duplicate values. These duplicate values now has become a key column here, okay? Now here you have to identify which is a key column, and you have to identify which is a pivot key column. So you have to understand the name would become a key column here. So yeah, in the source it is not a key column, try to understand. So in the destination table, this name would become a key column. Try to understand that point. So key column, it is not in the source I'm talking about, it is there in the destination. So the name will become key because it will not allowing duplicates here, but it has duplicates. Now the Java MSBA, Java MSBA called, you know, rows, this course itself is converted as a pivot. So this column is known as a pivot key column. So to demonstrate this, you have to identify what is a key column and what is a pivot key column. That you have to know mandatorily so that you can easily perform this demo. Okay, so let me quickly go to this. So let go here. Package. So drag and drop data flow tabs, double click on this and go to, you know, you have to add sources. The source here would be flat file source. Double click on this and flat file connection manager, click new and so give the name as flat file source and browse. We have a pivot source is the file we have already, and normally this data will be given by the customer, so you don't need to worry about it. So this is our data. Now you can preview once again if you want to, and my data is ready, and you have to drag and drop pivot transformation from other transformations and create a link. This, and here you have to understand which is a pivot key and which is a set key. So when you go back to your PPT, so pivot key is course here and key is name here. So this is what you have to be clear with. So go here. So pivot key is course, is, you know, a name here, right? And the pivot value is this. So this is the pivot values. Marks is the pivot value, the third column. So that we have to go here and marks. Now here we have to understand what are the two things you wanted to convert. So I want to convert Java MSBA. Java MSBA I wanted to convert. So Java MSBA you have to give and get the value. So here you have to give those values. So Java is one. You have to provide what are the values you wanted to convert. Those values you have to just, you know, give and generate columns. Now click OK. Now you'll have Java marks and you'll have MSPA marks. Okay. So step number one, you have to choose the pivot value. Then step number two, set the name. And step number three is that you have to choose the pivot value. Step number three, what values you wanted to have as a column. So Java MSPA. If you have one more course, that you have to also include here. So these you have to put Java and MSPA and click on generate columns new now. Okay. And the data would be coming here. So click on okay. That's it. Very simple. Now, so take JDB destination or any other destination if you wanted to have. So drag and drop this. You can also take Excel destination. This and OLEDB connection manager. So let me go to company database and create it. Let me create a table because I don't have the destination table here. And click on new. So when you click on new, you will be getting this. So okay. Say pivot that I wanted to have. I wanted to simply have simply Java, not need not be marks and all of them. Simply you can put Java, and here also you can say simply say MSBA. So this is the table I'm going to create. Okay, you can change the remaining things, the marks, integers, and all of them. If you wanted to change, you can change later. So as of now, so create table pivot data. Click on OK. You have to click on mappings. Okay. When you click on mappings, it's not able to identify. So what data you should go here? So name and name, both of them are matching, right? It is able to give you the mapping. So here the column name is different. So the column name is different. It's not able to map. So you have to map. Okay. It's very, very important that always you have to click on mappings, and now it will be perfect. Click on OK. Now save and execute the package. When you save and execute the package, six rows we have, and now you got three rows here. So stop debugging and quickly go back to your SQL Server and write select that from pivot data. That is the thing we have taken. So pivot the data and execute. Now this is the database you should be able to have, and there is a, this one called pivot data, and I have Kiran, Ravi, John. So the source data you had like this, and this kind of a data you are able to create like this. So this is what is called pivot transformation. Okay, doing it reverse order is known as the unpivot transformation. So have you clear with what is a pivot operation? So this is the pivoting operation. So we had that this kind of a data another than the destination. Let me do it unpivot also. So what is unpivot now? Unpivot is I have the this should be your source file. Now you wanted to do it in reverse order. Okay, now here step number one is that you have to check converted back as row. So I wanted to convert Java and MSBA. I wanted to convert as row. So you have to check that. Then second step, provide destination as marks here. So here you have to provide a destination. And third step, you have to provide the course here. So these you have to perform. So let me quickly do this demo also so that you should be able to understand. So let me go back to our package and take new package. Now let us do a demo on, you know, unpivot transformation. So go here, drag and drop a data flow task. I click on this, so you should be able to get this data flow task here. And now the source for us is OLEDB source because the data is in this table, pivot data. So this is my source table. So quickly go here, double click on this, and connection is new connection. Okay. And the table you have to choose is pivot data, and this is my source data. Click close and okay. Now take from other transformations, I think you have unpivot also here. So drag and drop click a link, double click on this, and check what is that you wanted to have. You have to, as we've seen, you have to check this and this. So that is step number one. Okay. Now step number one, check columns that need to be converted back as rows. This you have to check. So Java and MSP, that I have done it. Then here, the step number two, you have to provide. So Java and MSBA, you know, the destination column, the marks will be created here. So you have to provide marks here.